half to death. I've never seen that before. I was just tootling along looking for gold. Welcome back, everybody, to Influxus. It has been a while since I have done a video. I am finally back from my trip, and I decided to do a video on this game because, well, I had a hankering for it, and I also wanted to basically kind of get the game done in a way, because I will have made basically the most useful stuff, I believe, besides the flashlight, because I don't really think we need that, really. Maybe in the next episode I will try to make this stuff. I'm not sure if I really need the reinforced suit because I assume that just adds some extra armor. And I really don't think I get hit that much. I don't get damaged really that often. So I don't really think we really need the reinforced suit. I want to see what these things are because I have no clue what the heck these are used for. But I kind of want to get this first because I assume this makes us go faster. Or it's a gun, but I assume it makes us go faster. So we're going to try and get that. So I have some junk laying around just because I needed to make some space. But I need a bunch of items. I need iron, I need copper, I need some coral fragments. I basically just need everything. And I also need some silica or whatever the heck it's called. So we gotta find some of that stuff. I'm thinking about going over that way because I think that's the area I have not gone to yet. So I think that's the plan for today. Let's just grab some of this iron I need. Ooh, that was 4 iron. Wow, that was a lot of iron. That might be actually all we need. I think it's 5 iron per ingot, which is a lot. And I need, I believe, 3, if not more. 3 ingots, that is. So I have 1 ingot right now, so I probably need maybe 10. So I have 1, 2, 3, 6... Yeah, I need like 2 more. What is that? Oh, that's my robot dude. So I need just a few more, I believe. I don't think I have any more at home. Maybe I have 1 or 2 at home. But just to be safe, I'll probably just grab 2 on this trip. Now, I am going to need a boatload of copper because I need to make a bunch of copper wires. And I think those take 3 each, and I believe I need 4. Of those copper wires, and by my calculations that's going to be a lot of copper that I'm going to need. So that's like what, 12, something like that. So yeah, it's going to be a lot of copper. I assume there's going to be some copper in these. What is this? I guess it's more metal scrap. I didn't know what that was, but anyway, yeah, so I'm assuming we're going to find some copper in this area because that I feel like would make sense. This oxygen tank, this extended oxygen tank, is very, very nice. Oh, here's some copper right here. Just 1, unfortunately. Let's see if we can find some more around here. I'm getting a little bit of lag. I think I actually need some of these kelp samples. Maybe not. If I run out of room, I will drop those because I'm not exactly sure if I need them, but I'm thinking I do. Ooh. I have no idea what these are for. Not exactly sure. Some kind of alien sacrifice altar, it looks like. I have no clue. Maybe a portal or something. There is one on the land as well. I just swam right over this chest. Let's grab this. Let's hope for copper. Oh yeah, a bunch of copper in here. That was good. Okay, so we got a bunch, but we're still gonna need a lot more. Let's eat this guy. Or a little fish egg. So it actually looks like we're gonna get this done a lot faster than I thought it would. I've only been playing for a few minutes and I am finding a ton of copper. This is where the chest was, actually. It's just right over there. So we might be able to make this rather quickly. Let's grab 1 more iron just for good measure. And I think that should be good. How much copper do I have? I have what,
20%
like
oxygen.
9? I have 9 or so copper with me. Let's just grab a few more. I'm definitely going to need a lot, so it can't hurt to have a bunch. I'm gonna need some food as well. I don't really think I have any food, so I have to look around possibly for some more. Oh, I better breathe. That's important. Let's head back to the base over here and whip up some copper wires. I do believe we still need the coral samples, but I think there might be some in this little bay area where the crash ship is, our base is. So that shouldn't be too hard to find, or at least I'm assuming there's some coral fragments because I remember them some being there. Someone actually commented that I should play Subnautica because it is much like this game, and I have actually played Subnautica, and I did almost finish the game twice, but every time I'd play Subnautica, there was always a game-breaking glitch. And like, and by game-breaking, I mean like my, the submarine, the Cyclops, would like literally get stuck in a wall, and it would like glitch inside of it, and I could not get back in it, and that really sucked, and that happened twice. So I kind of gave up on that game, and I vowed never to play it, but I was kind of thinking about getting into it, because it is a really fun game. It is much like in this game. These do have a lot of, like, you know, similarities, but they are different in their own unique ways. So I do like both of these games, since they offer different kind of, you know, crafting and things like that. Alright, so we're going to need, I believe, one more copper? I meant, yeah, well, maybe two more wires. So, like, five more copper, maybe? Because we need two computer chips and two wires. Each computer chip takes what? Takes two wires, so that's what? Six copper each. Yeah, so we're gonna need more copper. Probably, I should probably make a little bit more as well, just in case I want to make these things, because all of these take wires and other things. Computer chips, that's what they're called. Alright, so I whipped up two more iron ingots. That should be good, I believe. I need to store some of this stuff, but storage is a problem in this game. It is a lot of management and storage, because, well, you can't hold very much. And there's not, you can't make chests in this game, unfortunately. That would be a good improvement in the game if you could add chests. So I might have to drop some of the scrap metal and some of the silica, because I don't really know what it's used for. Maybe it's used for cooking or something. I can't imagine silica would be used for that, but maybe it is. Maybe it is. On my search right now, I'm gonna look for some more copper, two more gold, and some coral fragments. But I believe the coral fragments are in this little bay area, if I'm not mistaken. Can I eat you? No, I can't. Oh, I saw it for a second. And he's not letting me pick him up. Seems like if you go down below, maybe. Oh, there we go. Sometimes it's hard to catch those fish for some reason. Not seeing any coral. Oh, wait, this is it right here. There we go. So we should be good for that, because I didn't really need that many. I think I just needed four more. So that should be plenty right there. Now I literally just need the copper and the gold. Gold should be a lot more easy now that I have this extra oxygen. It's like three times as long. Well, maybe twice as long. So I really don't have to worry about what is that floating in the water. I really don't have to worry about breathing as much. Why is there a block of barracuda fish? I'm not complaining, it's free food. Let's go over this way. Is this more silica? Yeah. Let's go over this way. I think this is where the gold is, if I'm not mistaken. It's in this ravine area. If you guys have made it this far in the video, thank you so much for watching. Yeah, you just interrupted me. But anyway, if you guys could possibly maybe leave a like if you enjoyed, maybe leave a comment of what I did good or what I could do better to help me improve my gameplay in my videos, because I really do enjoy this. Can I hate you? Yes, I can. But yeah, it really does just help to know what I could do better. And also, the likes do help support my channel, so that is super nice if you guys could possibly do that. I am having the worst time finding gold. I have found a buttload of copper. I have, I think, more than enough, I believe. I think I might actually have to drop some. I need to eat some of this fish because I'm starving. So let's eat that. I think I'm good. I think the last thing I need is gold, and I'm having a hard time. So I'm thinking about going a little bit more left. I thought it was in this area, but I might be, and I am probably mistaken, but I know it's in these like ravines.
20% oxygen.
And there is also a cave underneath the water around here that has gold in it, and I remember that distinctly because I almost died in it like twice. That's silver. I really don't need any more silver. There's a bunch of copper. Don't really need copper. I have enough, I do believe. I probably don't have enough, and I'm gonna regret not grabbing that. But for the time being, I'm running out of space. I just need gold. There's some more silica. Don't need that. I have quite a bit of that as well. Better go up to the surface and get some more oxygen. There's some more copper. It would be kind of cool if possibly you needed like a
oxygen remaining.
Yeah, okay. If you needed like a pickaxe or something, that's a new fish. to check that guy out. But if you need, maybe if you had like a pickaxe or something that you needed to extract that ore, that'd be pretty cool if you actually had to mine some of the minerals. That way it's a little bit harder to actually get some of the supplies. Let's check out this guy. He's like a stingray. Try not to get so close because, you know, they're pretty deadly. They killed that guy. That's cool. He's got like little eyes and... Whoa! Where'd he go? I lost him. That was odd. Oh, there he is. That was bizarre. He like just vanished. I wonder if I can eat him? Oh. Alright, so apparently these guys are like ghost fish or something because he just keeps vanishing on me. I can't eat him, unfortunately. He looks pretty tasty. He looks like he has a steak. He looks like he's a steak right in the center there. See, doesn't that look delicious? But we can't eat him. Let's just move on and look for some more gold. Scared me half to death. I've never seen that before. I was just tootling along looking for gold. Wow. Whew. That gave me a heart attack. I thought it was like a volcanic tube at first, and I was like, what is that? Well, now my curiosity is piqued, but I really don't want to die. I know nothing really happens when you die. But, you know I have to check it out, because that was pretty cool. That was totally random. Let's go back down here and see if he comes at me again. Was he in... I think he was down here, wasn't he? Man, that scared me half to death. That was a very good jump scare. Is there anything down there that I can use? There's, like, no indication that he's down there. I really don't want to get that close because I feel like he's going to kill me. I'm scared. Alright, I'm just going to swim across here. Maybe that was just a one-time thing? I imagine not. I imagine it's still there. Ooh. I feel like there's something good down here.
20% oxygen remain.
Okay, well, apparently not. I gotta go back up. I think that might have been a one-time thing. I'm not exactly sure because he's gone now. There's the jellyfish clan. And now I'm gonna die of... gosh dang it. Well, that sucks. Hey, well, that was a little nice teleportation to my base. Let's make up some wires just to clear out my inventory a little bit. Oh yeah, we have more than enough wires, I do believe. We have 4 being made, so that should be just dandy. So at the moment, we literally just need 2 more gold. That is all we need, and then we can get this propulsor or whatever the heck it is. I don't know if it's a gun or like a little scooter thing we ride on. No clue, but we gotta find this gold, and I have the hardest time finding gold all the time, and I always find it when I don't want it, and I don't pick it up, but I probably should, because I have a hard time seeing it, and there's also weird tentacly things apparently in the water that I have not seen, so I have to be a little bit wary about that now, I guess, when you go in the depths of the water. Still not seeing any gold. Thinking maybe I have to go really far left. There are some really deep like ravines right here, but there's nothing ever in them. Maybe this chest has some stuff. I might have already gotten this. Yeah, it looks like I've actually gotten that chest before, so I've probably been here. But I keep finding caves like this, but I'm not seeing any type of gold. Unless I'm just blind. I don't know what those are. It's like just lumps. Oh no, that's just more lumps. You'd think there would be something in these caves, because they're super deep and super dangerous. If I can just find 2 gold... Oh, there's one right there. Alright, I just need 1 more gold, and then I can die, and then I can just teleport to my base. I bet there's gold in here. I don't know why I've been in here before. That sucks. So apparently that's why I have not found very much gold, is because I've taken it before.
20%
I thought it would have respawned,
remaining.
But maybe not. So we gotta find... Oh, there we go. Okay, I didn't grab that chest, apparently. So we are good. We are good to die now. I can just teleport to my base. I think what happens when I die is that my robot friend grabs me and drags me to the surface. Or at least that's what I'm claiming, because it's just kind of weird. I black out underneath the water, and then I just appear in my base. And welcome back. We are safe and sound, and we should be able to make that propulsor. So I'm super excited. We'll make 2 computer chips, and I think that should be good. Oh, I need to grab some stuff over here as well. Oh, I need to grab the charges, 2 charges, and some coral samples. Oh, my mistake. I actually don't need the coral samples because I already made the computer chips. So I think that should be it, right? No, I need my iron ingots. I have one in here. I keep going back and forth between these chests. I have like short-term memory loss and I can never remember what I need. All right, so that should be good. I should have everything now. So let's make this bad boy up. Let's hopefully he's worth it. And there we go. Let's see. Do we put it in... There we go. So we put it right in there. Oh, yeah, it is. Whoa. We have hands? We have arms? I didn't know that. I only saw our hands before. So does this actually make us go faster? Oh, yeah. That makes us go way faster, but actually it deep. Look how fast it's depleting our energy. That's insane. Well, is it really worth it? Does it degrade when I'm not even moving? Oh, it does. All right, so how do we take this off? I guess we'll have to use that when we're being lazy, because I don't want to waste all my charges, because they're hard to make. Suppose I could always just go to, I think, maybe over there? There's some batteries in a chest. I'm thinking there's some batteries over there as well, so I could always just make runs over there all the time. Grab some batteries, because we only drove for what, like 10 seconds? So it's about 1% per second of the energy drain, which is insane. So that means these only last for about 100 seconds. That might want to be rebalanced, because I feel like that's a lot, and you might as well not even use this, because you're going to be transferring batteries in and out of it all the time. But maybe in emergencies, I guess that would be really nice. So we can always just keep an extra battery and that on hand for when we need it. I think I'm going to leave it off here, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I'm glad to be back making videos. It's been a while since I've done a video on this game. Apparently, it doesn't want to scan me. But anyway, I will see you guys next time.